It was a random day when my father asked me to accompany him on one of his work trips. He was going down to the southern border of Kenya, and I accompanied him on his trip to Ilbisil Primary School in Kajiado. Here, I got to meet teacher Lucy and her team, who spent their evenings risking their lives to rescue girls from early marriages, female genital mutilation, and other unfounded practices that were highly common in the Maasai community. One girl I remember is Rebecca. At the time, she had a fractured pelvis and had only recently been rescued from her marriage with her 60-year-old uncle. I couldn't imagine having to go through something like that, and as I thought about my sister at home, who was a similar age, I found it truly heartbreaking that there were girls all around Kenya and all over the world experiencing similar things. I spoke with others who told me about the times they were banished from their homes. During their menses, women are deemed unsanitary and are unwelcome to stay at their houses. Many would have to make sanitary towels out of toilet paper, newspaper, or cardboard. And for those who could not, they would spend the majority of their cycles sat atop of a hole. I also made a point to speak to the boys, understanding that they played an equally important role in effecting the change that we all wanted to see in their community. After having done the project for nearly 5 years, I realized that we are far away from reaching a solution, but a conversation is the first step. My friends and I talk to those, anyone who's willing to listen, and even those unwilling to listen, to our cries for the need of change. My father always stressed the importance of going out and effecting the change that he wanted to see. He showed me that I am capable and powerful and knowledgeable enough to make these changes. And I vow to continue to stand for and fight with girls in Kenya, Africa, and the world at large.